Hi, I just want to welcome you to my Facebook Live as I begin to press into a thought that I begin to learn really well as I was journeying in my relationship with the Spirit of God and just getting into a friendship, getting into a really deep communion with the Holy Spirit. And I began to learn that I don't understand Him and I don't understand everything He does. And that's okay. I don't have to understand everything. I just need to follow. And so I'm going to press into that thought in just a few moments, but I'm going to give you some time to just come on board and share this Facebook Live with your friends on your page as well. Let me know your name and where you're from. Someone said they're from Canada. Hello. Let's see. Jennifer, it's good to see you. Kim Mason, good to see you. Rebecca, it's good to see you. Now, I want to make sure that you have your copy of Glory Carriers. This book is going everywhere, and I'm hearing incredible testimonies, a lot of different directions. Some people are just like, it's just really moving them because it's actually giving them permission to get in a relationship with the Holy Spirit that they didn't know that they could have. Others are experiencing the miraculous. They're getting this book and all of a sudden the miracle realm is opening to them. So I want to encourage you to get the book. If you go on Amazon, it has a Kindle version, audio version, paper version, or you can hit the shop now button, get a signed copy from me, you know, right up top at the top of the page. And then also we decided that if you want to get all three books, you know, Seeing the Supernatural is my second one, my first one, The Intercessor's Handbook, this is going to blow your mind when it comes to intercession. I just have this thing that when we pray, we need to get results. And so this is the journey of how to get results when you pray every time. And so anyway, if you want to get all three, hit the shop now button, you'll get three for 33. Okay. So anyway, I just want to let you know about that. Also my mentorship, my online mentorship group is going to restart in June. We test flighted an online mentoring group this whole past year, and I was very, very happy with the results. It's very community oriented, and I get to see a lot of you at some of the events that I do across the country, even overseas. It's been great to just connect with you in person here at the institutes as well, for those of you who have been in my online mentorship. And so we actually are gonna restart, do another year's worth, different topics though, June to May. And you can see the details at jenniferevazonline.com/next-course/. And I actually put that little address right in the title line so you don't have to remember what I just said. But click in there and get the details. We're gonna start in June, but there's a real good discount going if you sign up in the next couple weeks, okay? Some things I do have going on, I'll be at the Marvel Dallas Conference. That is the 25th through the 27th. Go to marveldallas.org, and that's April 25th through 27th, and of course over in Dallas, Texas. And then I will be at Tribe Byron Bay in Australia, and I'll be doing their Sunday service on May 5th. That's at 3 p.m. You can just go onto Tribe Byron Bay and get the information. And I'll also be doing the School of Freedom and Breakthrough. Now that's gonna be heavy. Again, over in Australia with Tribe Byron Bay, May 9th through 11th. And you can actually get that information on their website or on their Facebook page. I would love to see you if you are in Australia, or you just actually wanna take the jump over and go there. Then I will be in, it's looking like Tampa, Florida for the Revive Women's Conference, the 17th and 18th. So just go to revivetampa.org and dig around for the information for that. And then coming into June, what do I have going in June? Looks like I will be at Life Church in Salem, Oregon at the end of June. I got a bunch of TV interviews coming up ahead of that, but I won't, that's nothing I need to announce here. And then July, we have the Holy Spirit Conference here at Harvest Christian Center. I'll also be in Rochester, New York. Looks like around the 11th through the 14th with G-Force Ministries. And I'll be back in Tampa towards the end of the month with the Fearless Conference with Valora Cole. So a bunch of stuff coming up. I can keep going. Bunch of stuff coming up. I hope to see you there. But anyway, I just want to make sure that you got the book, Glory Carriers, and that you're going to, and I would love to see you in our online mentorship group. It's really, really good. Okay, so let's talk about the thought that I want to really talk to you about today, that this whole need to understand everything that God does. You don't need to understand everything that God does. You need to follow. And some people are really worried that they're going to get led into something that's, you know, like they might stumble into something that's demonic or counterfeit. Well, that's really, you know, if you have a relationship with your word, you know, with your Bible, then you will be able to discern, you know, what is the Holy Spirit, what is not the Holy Spirit. And, you know, he leads you into truth. He leads you into peace. Okay. And he is your comforter. He is your advocate. And so you can trust that. But what was really beginning to awaken in my life over this past year, and again, it was connected to writing this book, Glory Carriers. You know, I would say I had a growing relationship with the Holy Spirit. And it seems like, you know, the more you get into this relationship with him, it's almost like you scratch the surface. He just very multifaceted, multidimensional, you know, unending revelation about who he is. And I always feel like the minute I know something, there's like 100 more things I don't know, 1,000 more things I don't know. So, you know, just keeps me fascinated. But at the same time, when you have a supernatural friend, his supernatural gets on you and you begin to operate in signs and wonders quite naturally. But what I've come to discover is that he does not do miracles in our box. And actually, he's really, you know, wanting to educate the body of Christ, educate you and I, that he's going to do what he's going to do. And he has a very fierce side to him. You know, when he goes after something, there's a very fierce side to him. He is the dove, but he's also you know, the lion. And so he goes after these things. And, you know, unusual miracles. I mean, I've seen more unusual miracles this year. That's why I'm looking forward to Dallas and Australia, because I know he's going to drop glory bombs and do things that, you know, like just defies natural laws, defies what we really think we know about him. I mean, I've seen people lose weight supernaturally. I've seen people grow hair supernaturally. I've seen people get money in their bank accounts supernaturally. And that blows my mind. Okay. You know, and I've just seen, you know, I've seen a lot of people, I wouldn't say a lot. I've seen enough that, you know, more than I ever have this year. Let's be accurate. People, you know, being given their ability to walk again, run again, getting pain out of their bodies, the spirit of heaviness being, you know, removed from their lives, and they're able, you know, to get their energy all back where they could barely get out of bed. And, you know, I'm just seeing these kind of miracles. I'm thinking about the miracle of the gold teeth in the mouth. That was one I saw through Charlie Champ. And you know, he was here to institute, and people started getting gold teeth in their mouth. And that was pretty controversial, because people had these questions, like, well, why would God do that? And what was the point of that? It's like almost like we want to question what the Creator does. And I'm like, why would you question that? Do you have to approve that miracle? You know what I'm saying? And we don't have to approve those miracles. I mean, we have to weigh them and judge them, but he's going to do what he's going to do. And you know, we don't have to understand everything. We just need to follow, because God is way bigger than us, okay? Way bigger than us. And he's going to start doing miracles that we have not seen before, okay? And he does that, you know, that's consistent, you know, with the Bible. The Bible says that we are going from glory to glory, and the earth will be filled with the knowledge of the glory of the Lord. And what is the glory of God? It's his manifest presence. It's his demonstration. And so these miracles are, you know, they're just going to unfold, just like he's unfolding himself to us, his nature to us. And so we're going to be engaged. We're going to be seeing miracles that we haven't seen before. And, you know, don't get offended. Don't judge it. You know, he's just going to do what he's going to do. And, you know, don't question if he should do that or not. You know, the people on the recipients of the miracles are the ones that are so happy, and then to be criticized. You know, we even see that kind of pattern in the Bible, you know, when the blind man got his sight back supernaturally, you know, he got a miracle, and, you know, everybody kept questioning, well, you know, how did you get your sight back? You know, the Pharisees started questioning, how'd you get your sight back? The guy just got a miracle. My goodness. So we don't want to be that kind of person, and we think that it's not us until we run up against a miracle that we don't understand. And so you don't have to prove every miracle. You just need to follow the one who's releasing the glory and the miracles, okay? All right, and I love your question, Cynthia. Who are we to question God? And I agree with you. And, you know, to be honest with you, I've been up against some things that, you know, I'm like, really? Is that really something God did? Like this whole financial miracle, Cynthia Gibbons, this whole financial miracles where people literally, money shows up in their account. I saw 15,000 collectively show up in people's bank accounts at the last institute. And I mean, I got the word, I called out the word, and the instruction I got was tell them to look at their bank account and then shake their phones in the air and then recheck their bank account. That's crazy. Collectively, by the time it's all done, there's about $15,000 that dropped. And, you know, I'm thinking, well, are they tithers? Are they faithful with their money? Are they stewards? I mean, just all these dumb thoughts. And I had to just let that go because God's going to heal your body. He's going to heal your mind. And he's going to heal your finances. All right. He's going to heal your finances. And so anyway, I'm even my own self, I'm having to coach myself that I don't have to approve of that miracle. All right. Well, I hope that helps you. And make sure you get the book Glory Carries. I hope to see you online with our online mentorship. God bless.